Streamlit is always adding new features and improving existing ones. In this video, I will show you 5 features from the latest releases that you might have missed. So without further ado, let us dive in.
First things first, if you want to try out the features I'm about to show you, make sure you're using the latest version of Streamlit. To do that, just run pip install streamlit --upgrade in your command prompt or terminal. Okay, and with that said, let me show you the first thing that you might not know. In Streamlit, you can actually use emojis and Google material icons. In this example, I used the markdown field, and inside it, I've included a material icon which looks like this. So if you want to include icons in your next application, head over to the Google material icons page. Here you can browse and search for different icons. Once you find one you want to use, just click on it and scroll down in the window that pops up to find the name of the icon. And now you can just use this name here in your application. Alternatively, you can also use emojis. If you are on Windows, you can open the Emoji Picker by pressing the Windows key and period. Now, inserting icons and emojis aren't limited to just markdown and button elements. They're actually supported in many other elements too. Okay, and the next thing I want to show you is the segmented control widget. This feature was added with Streamlit version 1.41. And with it, you can include a selection widget just like this one here. Whatever you select will be returned as a list if the selection mode is set to multi. And you can actually combine it also with the materials icon we have just seen. For example, I created a dictionary with my options, and inside it, I included the different icons. Then I used those options in the segmented control element. And now we've got this cool widget right here. Alright, and next up is the pills element, which is very similar to the control widget we just saw. But instead of a button group, you can now have pills. Just like before, you can set them to multi or single select. Okay, and next up, here's something that is not a new element, but a new attribute for a Streamlit button. So far, there were only the primary and secondary button types. But with Streamlit version 1.41, you can now also have the tertiary button type. This one looks more like a regular text, but it functions just like a normal button. Alright, and last up, we've got one of my favorite features added to Streamlit, the ability to use custom CSS on certain elements. And here's how it works. First, I loaded a CSS file, which I will show you in just a second. Now, whenever a Streamlit element has a key attribute, you can apply your custom CSS to that element. In my example, I applied it to a button. So for the first button, I created a green button style. And for the second one, I added a pulse effect. In my case, I saved my CSS file inside an assets folder and called it style.css. Then, in the CSS file, I targeted the elements by writing stkey followed by the name of the key I had defined. So for the first button, the key was green, and here I adjusted the CSS for that. And I did the same also for the pulse effect. Now if you want to learn more about custom CSS, I already have a full tutorial on this feature. You can check it out by clicking the button here. By the way, I've also deployed this application with all the examples, and you can find the link to it in the description box below. Alright guys, and that was a quick overview of 5 features you might have missed. Let me know in the comments which one's your favorite. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.